All right, Shalom. First and foremost, I want to begin this lesson by giving all praises and all honor and all glory unto my power, Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai Bahasham Rechak Wadash. Yahweh is the true holy name of the Heavenly Father, who this world ignorantly calls God. Yahweh Shai is the true name of our Lord and our Savior, who this world ignorantly called Jesus. And the Rechak Wadash is the Holy Spirit. Also want to give double honors to my apostles and elders of Great Millstone, who are the true leaders of the nation of Israel that Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai has set up through the Holy Spirit to lead and to guide, and also be great examples for the nation of Israel. I also want to say Shalom to the 144,000 men who are laboring and toiling in his work for the sake of Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai. I also want to say Shalom to the innumerable multitudes consist of the men, women, and children who Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai will show his mercy upon in these last days. And I'm the brother Gabar from the GMS West Palm Beach Camp. I'm coming back with another Lord's willing edifying lesson to feed the sheep of Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai unto the best of my ability. And the name of this lesson is going to be entitled, Woe Unto Them Who Trust in Man. And the inspiration for doing this lesson, I just had an encounter with a Jake, you know, and he was passing out pamphlets, you know, and that's what you see on the screen. You know, right here you see a man who's supposed to be running for I can't remember if it was governor or mayor. And you know, the guy came up to my house and you know, trying to persuade me to vote, you know. And basically, you know, I'm speaking to the Jake, you know, telling him that all these governors, all these mayors, these presidents, they sold out, you know, just going back and forth with the Jake, all right, letting them know that, you know, I'm voting for Yahweh Shai, all right? I'm voting on Yahweh Shai, man. You know, look at all these years, all these decades that our people has been voting for mayors and public officials. And what has it done? What has it done? Nothing. And this person that you see is just another sellout. All right, all he care about is his money. You know, but he's not serving the Lord. And that's what the guy was saying. He's a man of God. Well, you know, the Lord gives us discernment. All right, you look at this picture off rip, you know, this man is not a man of God. All right, he has a line up. He shaved his beard off, you know. So hold on, let's get this scripture. Yeah, man, because, you know, none of these men is going to be able to save you. They're not going to bring any change. All right, because this earth was given into the hand of the wicked. And you have our people who's joint hand in hand with this devil. Matter of fact, let's open up with that. All right. This is Proverbs 11 and verse 21. And though hand join in hand, the wicked shall not be unpunished. All right. And this Jake that you see, most likely from the tribe of Levi, which are the so-called Haitians. All right. This man is joint hand in hand with the wicked. You know? It says, though hand join in hand, the wicked shall not be unpunished. All right. All our people who's joint hand in hand with this devil, Esau, Edom, the so-called white nation, they're going to be punished right along with him. It says, but the seed of the righteous shall be delivered. Right? Who is the seed of the righteous? That's the elect. All right? Beginning with the 144,000, which are the prophets. And then you have the innumerable multitude. All right? Those are the ones who's going to be delivered. You know? And these governors, these mayors, you know, it's not going to save you. Okay? Because they not following after Yahweh Shemal Shai. All right? And the guy said, you know, I was speaking about, you know, going into a little bit of scriptures with him. I ain't telling him he was an Israelite or anything like that. But, you know, just let him know that, you know, we at the end. All right? I was telling him. You know, look at all these things going on in the world. You know, you got the wars and the rumors of wars. People are seeing mass amount of chariot sightings. All right, you got all these false prophets. You're hearing about more pestilence, earthquakes in diverse places. You know, so we gotta continue to trust in Yahweh Bashem Al Shai. Okay. Let's get this real quick. Let's go to the book of Psalms. Psalms. What's that? Psalms 118, I believe. Yep. Psalms 118 and starting at 6, it says, The Lord Yahweh is on my side. I would not fear. What can man do unto me? All right, because the Lord didn't give his true men of the Lord, the true believers, the spirit of fear, but of power. But we got the spirit of power, which is the scriptures, man. Hebrews 4:12 says the word is sharper, is powerful than any two-edged sword. So the Lord didn't give us the spirit of fear, but he gave us to be a power and of a sound mind. Okay, because the time of the destruction is coming, the time of Jacob's trouble. All right, where the Lord is really about to judge these people. He's really about to judge the wicked of our people, because judgment must begin at the house of the Most High. All right, it says verse 7, the Lord taketh my part with him, with them that help me. Therefore shall I see my desire upon them that hate me. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. Right? And that was a scripture that I thought about once the Jake departed. It's better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. You know, so you got our people voting for these presidents, voting for these governor officials. They put in their confidence in man. They put in their confidence in Leroy Kelson. You know, that's who people are putting their trust in. All this chaos going on in the world, these people not seeking after Yahweh Shemal Shai. Why? Because they really don't believe. They really don't fear the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. All right? They put their trust in America. But the scripture says in the book of Isaiah, the 30th chapter, let's go there. I believe it's 30 or 31. Yep, this is Isaiah 31:1. Woe to them that go down to Egypt for help. Right? And America is modern day Egypt. All right, Revelations 11 chapter speaks about that. And also, you look at the back of your dollar bill. You got the Egyptian pyramids, okay? And it says, and stay on horses and trust in Pharaoh. And stay on horses and trust in chariots, because there are many, and in horsemen, because they are very strong. But they look not unto the Holy One of Israel, neither seek Yahweh Shemal Shai. Right? So that's the mindset of the wicked of our people. All right, they're not putting their trust in Yahweh Shemal Shai. They're not seeking the Lord in these evil days. And the days are about to get more evil. Okay? Esau, Edom about to come down with great wrath, because he knoweth that he has but a short time. All right? We're about to go through the time of 70 AD all over again. But the Lord says it's going to be worse than 70 AD. It's going to be worse than the transatlantic slave trade. You know? But the Lord is going to have a hedge of protection round about those who fear him. Those who put their trust in Yahweh Bashmal Shai. Okay? And let's get this. Let's go to the book of Jeremiah 17 and 5. It says, thus saith the Lord Yahweh, cursed be the man that trusteth in man. Right? Cursed be the man that trusteth in man. And you and these people showing that they trust in man by voting, you know, voting for Joe Biden, voting for these governors and mayors and different public officials. They trust in man, you know, and they're cursed. That's why the Lord is sending judgment upon our people. Our people getting smite with different plagues, getting smite with diseases and things of that nature. And it says, and maketh flesh his arm, and whose heart departed from the Lord. Right, that word heart in the Hebrew is lav, which speak about your mind. Our people's mind departed from Yahweh Bashmal Shai, man. Okay? Hey, the scripture says, rise and depart. So we're supposed to depart from this place spiritually. All right, and that's what the Lord's elect are doing. We're departing from this place spiritually. We're not trusting in ourselves. We're not trusting in man. We're trusting in Yahweh Bashmal Shai. But it's the complete opposite with two-thirds of our people. They're departing. They're separating from Yahweh Bashmal Shai. Instead of drawing nigh, they're separating from Yahweh Bashmal Shai. This is James 4 and 8. Draw nigh to the Most High, and he will draw nigh to you. Right? So in order to draw nigh to the Most High, all right, you got to keep his ways. You got to keep the law, statutes, and commandments. You know, you got to make a sacrifice in order to get closer to the Lord. It says, cleanse your hands, ye sinners, and purify your hearts, ye double-minded. All right, so we got to cleanse our hands from wickedness. All right, and trusting in man is wickedness. All right, voting for a wicked Jake is sin. Voting for these heathens are our sin. You know, and really two-thirds of our people, scripture says, John 8 and 44, ye are of your father the devil, and the lust of your father ye would do. So, yeah, our people are physically Israelites, but spiritually, they just as bad as Esau. Actually, the scripture says they surpass the deeds of the wicked, man. All right, Jake is into all type of witchcraft, idolatry. You know, they're serving idol gods. They're eating abominable foods, man. Hey, that's why the scripture says judgment must begin at the house of Yahweh Bashmal Shai, man, which is you Israelites, man. You know, so I was wanting to bring that out through the spirit, you know, because I just encountered, you know, this conversation with this Jake, man. All right, and that instantly gave me the spirit to make this lesson, you know. So we're going to continue to trust in Yahweh Bashmal Shai, the Lord's hopeful elect, okay? We don't trust in man. All right, our vote is in Yahweh Shai, man. All right, Yahweh Bashmal Shai, man. And the Lord's elect, the 144,000 going to be the next governors of the earth, next kings of the earth. Okay, the hell with these two-thirds. The hell with these heathens, man. So with that, I'm going to close out by giving all praises and all honor and all glory unto my power, Yahweh Bahashom, Yahweh Shai, Bahashom HaKodash. I want to give double honors to my apostles and elders of Great Millstone. Peace and blessings unto the hopeful elect, beginning with the 144,000 men who are laboring and toiling in his work for the sake of Yahweh Bashmal Shai. I also want to say Shalom to the innumerable multitude which consists of the men, women, and children who Yahweh Bashmal Shai will show mercy upon in these last days. And Thawadiyah Bashmal Shai, forgive me the spirit of truth. And Thawadiyah Bashmal Shai, forgive me the Holy Spirit. There were Chak Wadash to make this lesson. Lord is willing, until the next lesson, I'm going to say Shalom and the Baba Ball. DTA, Kwame Yashala, Shalom.